Colossus, Shadow of the Colossus, is a special game. For me personally, it's one of the most special, and my primary goal with this playthrough is to not only experience it again for myself, but also to express that appreciation to you, and I hope that you'll enjoy it. As per my Metal Gear Solid playthrough, I won't be speaking over any story sequences. The intro cutscene is a little lengthy, but the game is far from heavy on them, so without further ado, let's start playing.
Ushtu Hailwa Wukyu Raikwa. Ujik Riazu Tsudoko. Wash Nordekyo Uti Yula.
I will you. Aviuri Yuaizu. Sorumi
Yu. Izukumku. Idus Ordo Yu Iweriku. It's not all amusement. A little click if the least to is.
What's the answer? Is all you have? Ever proposed? Is all I'm not sure. You echo the you. At least not proof.
Our pet?
I was beautiful, not even kiss, not quarrels. On the zones around, I were confused. Ayo, what was he was called? He were confused. No one.
You do. You bet, Sanada.
Uku, I hope was no suit. Oh, you are mere kind of was you and beer only comes Zula, Ukira Jula. No suit.
Orlam.
You are the voice of the widow, the will you. Oyo, I'm a ship kid.
Orla, you do new.
And just like that, you have entered the world of Shadow of the Colossus. I adore that introduction. It does so much to establish the tone of the entire game in just a few short minutes. It's eerie, foreboding, and perhaps most pervasively, lonesome. I feel that the premise speaks enough for itself at this point, so I won't be talking about that until more story events unfold. First steps outside the shrine fill me with a very strong sense of nostalgia. I remember seeing just this small snippet of the seamless world in 2005 on my PS2 and being somewhat dumbfounded. I also remember fumbling with the controller and somehow discovering that you were able to stand on top of Agro, the horse, as she trotted along. Needless to say, I was very, very pleased. I'm going to go ahead and apologize now for how often I'll be panning the camera around to look at random crap in the environment and probably making aggro into various objects as a result. the horse controls have a tendency to be unwieldy at times, but I feel that it has the capacity to add a lot to the experience of riding to your destination all the same. There isn't too much to say about the map. As you progress through the world, the clouds disappear and unveil more of the geography to you, which is a very nice touch and a somewhat unconventional, smaller measure of progress alongside the more tangible number of colossi killed. Once again, I ask that you bear with me as I attempt to get a handle on the controls again. I promise that that dive roll directly into the wall was not intentional. Once you're in the vicinity of a colossus, you can hold up your sword's light to find the weak points of the creature. I never really got into the habit of using this feature, however, as I found it quite fun to find the points myself, so you most likely won't be seeing very much of it. Since we left the temple, the game has been completely devoid of music, but when we finally climb on top of a colossus with the intent to kill, it immediately kicks in. This exact setup won't be prevalent in almost all fights with the colossi, but as your first experience in the game's world, I feel it does nothing but make an extremely memorable soundtrack even more unforgettable. Truthfully, there isn't much to say about the fight with Valus, but he sets a lovely precedent for the level of animation quality that's to be found in this game. I'll be going more into that later, I'm sure, but with three stabs of the ancient sword, Valus falls. this was only the beginning of Wander's journey. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. See you next time.